Welcome to Revachol.
Don't you welcome to Revachol me. My grandfather came here from a 3,000-year-old racist isolationist culture, while your ancestors came to this island mere 300 years ago. Every school of thought and government has failed in this city, but I love it nonetheless. It belongs to me as much as it belongs to you. It's men like you who keep Revachol divided, making it that much harder for everyone to climb out of this post-war limbo.
Oh, come on, man. I just said welcome to him.
I know exactly what you meant. But you see, I'm an officer of the RCN. It's actually my job to make sure you behave. I would advise you to remember that.
Whatever you say, officers.
Yes.
Thank you.
Wait. She's just a distracted old woman. Better to leave her alone.
Bastards! We have a right to work! Pull up and stay frosty, everyone. Cops are here. Here to fuck with us? Beat the honest worker down? Good. We're fighting for a cause here. Right, too. Besides, we're not that different. It helps the people see us talking. Cops and strikebreakers together. Shows authorities are on our side. But might be time. Don't let the fat bastards tread on you. Cops tend to side with the higher-ups. But you're essentially... I don't trust cops, but I can see you understand the right. Maybe you should ask them the question. Like, we have families to feed, you piece of shit.
So do we, scab.
I was just messing with you. Imagine, you cops going... Speaking of, what brings the RCM here, to the Wild North? Come to see the strife?
Buddy betrays your degeneracy.
Yeah, Measurehead. His body totally betrays his degeneracy.
Are you admiring my morpho physiology? It must be frightening to stand in the shadow of this racial pinnacle. Be calm and sandwiched. You are not in danger. Because you are not a threat to me. That is precisely the negligence that has led you to succumb to Bangul. You reek of it. An invisible sword of Bangul emerges from your throat. You cannot see it, but others can. It is making the woman my company sick. No, you don't. You need to get another thing. Occidental Aplo Group B4 is done giving orders around here. The influence of the Amsondwish race is waning. Begging for help, attempting to pass via for cooperation. How far the Occidental Avenue has fallen. You were once a noble and powerful place. You gave the world eugenics, electricité, and powerful weapons of war like missiles and aerostatic aircraft. You made great gains in metallurgy, race theory and statecraft. You dominated lesser cultures, like the deformed Himians and the inexplicably potato-obsessed Koikos. But now your ascent to the genetic summit has halted. You are obsessed with sadness and with frivolous pop culture. You will be superseded. Isn't that right, babe?
It is, baby. Yeah, you know it.
It is my task to keep the degenerate grunts from entering the ark. Enough with this begging. Bring your troops to the seminar. The walls will be lined with bottles of Al-Ghul, your beloved beverage. Inside, we will store the oaths to homosexuality from art and your microcephalic skulls. The unpromising race pupil returns.
Him out good, like the flying desperado.
Native on the chief, huh? Those ballerina antics. Let's talk about our right to work.
Thank you. container, container, I'll turn you nice and red. Container, container, put the logos on. Container, container, used to be rat, rat, rat. He looks after everyone.
I see you're not a union man, mister. Did you get lost? You're not one of them scabs, are you? I mean, I don't personally mind. Folks is just folks, you know, and folks gotta eat. Just some of the other guys don't look too kindly on the scabbing kind, if you know what I mean, mister.
Welcome, Mr. Dubois, Mr. Kitsuragi. It's good of you two to stop by. Please, I'm Everard, Everard Clare, head of the Dubois Jersey. I'd offer you my hand, but unfortunately my health prevents me from getting up. You understand.
You go ahead, detective.
Please, Mr. Dubois, let us converse in a civilized manner as equals. Take a seat, I insist. Very well, Mr. Dubois. I respect a man with strong convictions. I, too, have convictions, one of which is that I will not engage any man who won't face me at eye level. Should you find yourself more amenable in the future, I'd gladly resume our conversation. But until then, I'm afraid I must ask you to leave.